how to use the selection brush tool in Affinity Photo to create amazing paint strokes very quickly with any colourful image. Key thing is, here, selection brush tool, select here. Unfortunately, there's no brush features where you can modify the brush in many ways. However, you do have, along here, some features. I'm going to go with add. Width, I'm going to go with 64, that's the default. Snap to edges, I'm going to avoid because I don't want to have it snap into other areas of color. All layers, I've only got one layer. I'm not going to turn that on. So just apply it. And you can just follow the path of certain lines in this, if that's what you want to do. Or maybe go around certain shapes. And you can make it as long or as short, but the best thing is avoid the edges. So just make certain when you draw it, just don't go over the edge, because you'll have to undo at that point, unless you want that sharp cutoff point. So you've got this selection. Then you can go to edit and copy and edit and paste. And then it just becomes a layer. And then you can remove the section. Don't need the section anymore, though I could use it, of course, create additional ones. You could create 4 or 5 different selections. Move that selection around. However, you've got this. You can go to effects, just down here at the bottom, click there, and I'm going to go with 3D. So click there and change radius. And you can make it fairly pronounced there. You can see that all the way around, and maybe go for outer shadow as well. You don't have to. Sometimes it doesn't always look great. So I'm just going to go with that intensity and click close. And you can always change your mind. You go to effects. Personally, I think that shadow doesn't look so great, so I'm just going to remove it. So you've got that, click close. It's just a layer and you can move it. See, it's within the bounds. I wanted to make certain it haven't gone over the edge by accident, and you can resize it. But you can also go up here to filters and distort and deform, or one of the others if you want. But deform is great. So I'm just going to go with similarity and then basically follow this. Just put it on the line itself. Now it would be brilliant if there was an automatic follow the selection and add handles. It would be lovely. I would love to see that feature, but I don't think that's ever going to happen. So you just put it all the way around. You don't have to have the whole thing, but you can add a few. And then as soon as you do that, you can see what happens. You can distort it. Now again, avoid going over the edges. Sometimes I find when I'm doing this, you go over the edge, you suddenly get a sharp edge. Sometimes you don't. Doesn't ever seem to be a logic, to be honest, in that. Shouldn't. I'm just doing some droplets there. Just drag those out. But I like avoiding going over edges anyway. Like to keep it in the center. And you can drag that out and drag that out. And create all kinds of weird and wonderful shapes. And you can always add additional ones. Drag it in. Droplets like that. So you've got your design there. Once you're happy with it. And I think that's a pretty sort of HP Lovecraftian Sea Anemone, sort of whole different types of shapes can be created using this. You maybe want to squeeze it in as well. You can apply other filters, of course, to squeeze it in. Maybe just simply just squeeze it in that way. Just transform it. You don't have to just use the deform. So you've got that design. And then hold down the alter option key. And you don't have to use the deform. I've just done the deform because I like to deform the, but you could just use it as exactly as the selection brush. And you can see then you can then rotate it and hold down the alter option key and again drag and create multiple copies, and all kinds of combinations created. In this case, I am going to go over the edge. I'm not worried about the edge now. I'm just dragging that in there. And you can see now. And of course, they're all going to look fairly similar unless you rotate it a bit or modify it slightly. So just twisting it, turning. And of course, you can always, if you want, go to filters and repeat deform. So the one that's got selected, just repeat it. Now the result maybe take a few seconds to process. You can see it's just taking some time, but literally thousands of possible combinations. And the result may be absolutely amazing. And sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. Undo again. Hold down the alter option key and then drag again. And with that, you've got your design. All kinds of weird and wonderful brushstroke designs can be created using this approach. And of course, once you've done that, you've got this design here, you can flatten the entire selection. So I'm just going to select all of them, select every one of them in the Layers panel, then go to Layer and down to Merge Selected. So they can be all merged selected. There's no flattened image per se in here. And there it is, all one layer, all nicely flattened in Affinity Photo. And of course you can warp, and if you wish, you can always again go to Selection Brush and follow areas here. And you can follow that around, just go down there, create all kinds of other weird and wonderful selections from this. And you can see as you do that, exact same as before, edit, copy, edit and paste. Select and deselect. And again, it's a layer. Just go here to effects, click there. And again, maybe 3D, click there. And now just change that, the radius setting to about 28, click close, and then you can move that around. And you can see the design there. And that combines, of course, all those other colors. Now you can also apply other effects. So maybe decide, you know what, blur and Gaussian blur. Just a bit of blur in there. Just a little bit, not too much. Click apply, and again, filters and distort and deform. And you can distort that as well. Again, similarity, always my favorite. Now it's actually a bit harder when you get to this point, unless you clear out the background. You might decide, you know what, let's just deselect that. Because to be honest, it's very hard to see once you get to a certain point where the actual selection is. Because they're all 3D, so therefore it's just tricky. And then you can create that. And of course, then you can drag that out. Again, I think prefer to avoid going over the edge. I'm just gonna squeeze that. And you can see you can create all kinds of other variations. You can push it up in a particular direction. You might like to squeeze it up so it's sort of stretching upwards in a particular direction. Up to you. And then click apply. And of course you've got that design. You can then duplicate that design. Hold down the Alt Option key and drag and resize and rotate, etc. And then once you're happy with that, and I'm obviously not going to create all the other layers, you can always just bring the other one back and you can see the design there. And you can move it around. But it does make it harder to see the actual design when you've got so many on that screen. Well, hope you found this tutorial of interest. Any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Always great to hear from you. How would you use this feature? How would you use these brush strokes? Do you think it's a great idea? Maybe you don't think it's a great idea at all. So please put in the comments below as well on that. Thank you much.